Have you seen those video sketches that have been popping up lately about bad customer service? This one's from Mad TV.
You see me in the middle of a conversation? Don't interrupt, bro. I'm gonna have to call you back.
And this one from a Mr. Bean cartoon.
And then what happened?
You can be rest assured that you won't see this nightmare service at the St. Vincent de Paul Sunny Slope thrift store.
In the back, familiar with the programs?
That's volunteer Patty Wright. She loves interacting with customers and making sure they get the best service possible.
Do various things. I can do electronics. I do clothing. I clean a lot. But my favorite is my Home Depot. It's my little baby. Because I like to organize, and back there it's sometimes unorganizable.
While Patty loves to organize and fix things, Aria Cortez especially likes working with
the clothes. I like doing everything. I cleaning everything and putting the pictures and the kitchens and everything.
By watching these women work and give countless hours to St. Vincent de Paul, one might ask, who inspired them?
My mother was a very kind, gentle person. She did, when we were in Florida, Red Cross work. So I always looked up to her for that. But she was always giving.
And Patty's giving, she says, also gets her out of the house.
7.5 years ago, my older son passed away.
Brandon was only 16, and by volunteering, Patty says she can focus on other things and help others at the same time. For Aria, her inspiration.
My mother, she all the time, she don't have a lot of money, but she give everything. Everything. And sometimes the people need food, she give the food. And when they go to the store, some people ask for money and she give the money. And that was it. When I wake up every morning, I'm alive, I'm okay, I don't got no problems.
It's like family. You come in, you're welcomed. It fills your heart. It gives you reason. It gives you energy. It gives you spirituality. It gives you all kinds of things that maybe you didn't think you had, but you do.
Think about it, you know, it's 106, that's on average. Right now, we're at 107 degrees and it's 540. The good news is, of course, as they always say, it's a dry heat, right?
Dry heat or not, anyone who has to work outside on cement and lift heavy objects in Phoenix in the summer deserves extra recognition. Anyone who is constantly in and out of a car, loading heavy boxes in Phoenix in the summer, deserves a moment in the spotlight. And oh, did I mention they are not getting paid? Vernon Rawls and Steve Labriola are volunteers at St. Vincent de Paul and don't seem to mind getting tired and hot.
Today I'm going to go pick up some bread from a couple places and deliver it out to the Sunny Slope branch. And I pull in there and unload it and see the homeless people that are there and realize that, you know, thanks to me and St. Vincent de Paul and a lot of other people, the people that donated, they're going to have something to eat today anyway.
I worked in the warehouse. I worked on the docks. I also worked in the kitchen, helped prepare lunch, dinner, pretty much anything they needed.
Vernon's boss says he treats the area wherever he's working just like it was his own home, and he always goes that extra mile without being told.
Vernon would be there straightening out the sofas or straightening up mattresses without being asked. He's out there, you know, out there just sweeping and making it clean so that our vendors come in and they have a different opinion of it. It's not just an auction that's thrown together. He made it presentable, you know, which helps the society to bring in more revenues to help the homeless and the needy.
So. And what about Steve?
Steve is a person that we can depend on to handle special projects for us.
And that means putting Steve in charge of very special possessions, the paychecks that he delivers to many St. Vincent de Paul locations.
And drop it off at Chandler.
Okay, thanks a lot.
And there was another special project That was different, but important to a special little one.
We had a donor donate some stuff by mistake. The donor contacted us and they wanted it back. It just happened to be a yellow duck, and it belonged to a younger person that he'd been having this yellow duck in his family for an extended amount of time. And so we searched, we found the duck, and Steve was able to take this duck back out and deliver it to the donor, and they was very happy and complimentary of you know, him bringing it out. So these are some of the things that Steve does for us. We can always depend on him.
If you're looking for something in return, then it's not really charity to me.
Steve doesn't plan to leave St. Vincent's anytime soon, but someday he wants to take his wanting to help others to the next level.
If I could help people to make themselves better, would be kind of a dream job, I guess.
I've never planted a tree a day in my life until St. Vincent de Paul. It was a pretty cool experience. I met different people. I also worked alongside with students from like another school. It was pretty cool. I mean, it was like really touching because everybody bonded in a certain way that I've never like seen before. I would love to go out and plant trees somewhere else. I mean, the experience I've got, I probably forgot a little bit of it, but I know I'm sure I'll be able to help plant another tree again.
A football player and a Marine.
A lawyer or a teacher.
I want to be a surgeon or a doctor.
I want to be a firefighter because you could stop the fire and you could save people's life.
These four siblings sure have lofty goals. Who would ever guess that this past year they lived in a homeless shelter with their dad?
Tonight, Patty Kirkpatrick visits with one family who needs help.
While this may look like a typical Arizona playground, it's actually part of a Salvation Army homeless shelter called the Kaiser Family Center.
I got a 14-year-old, 13-year-old, 11-year-old, and 9-year-old.
Gabriel Abasta was laid off in April, and so the single father of four was desperate to find a home. For the last few months, he's been living at the Kaiser Family Center, where all four kids share one bedroom.
I told the kids, you know, this is pretty much I see as rock bottom, you know? We can't go any lower than this.
Finally, things started looking up, way up.
Gabrielle is like an angel. She came out and helped us. Like I said, too, I was wondering how it came upon, you know, us getting chosen. I think it's just all God's will that, you know, he just put our name in Gabriella's hands and she took it from there.
The angel he's talking about is Gabriella Bova, who started the Fresh Perspectives program through St. Vincent de Paul. Once the Acosta family moved into their home, there was still lots and lots of work to be done. Leading the project, Noah Orr, who is working to become an Eagle Scout. He became a volunteer and brought lots of friends and family. Walls needed to be painted, windows clean. Oh, take a look.
I've got to hold steady, keep my head in the game. Everything is about.
My heart dropped because I was like, wow, cool.
Because you have more space and you have more freedom.
Everything is about to change. There's gonna be brighter days. Just might bend, but
I felt like I was a princess.
I was shocked because I never have had a room like that.
Felt amazing because we didn't think our house would be so nice, not the way it is now. And we really appreciate everything they've done. My heart dropped because I was like, wow, cool.
I felt like I was a princess because there was a lot of stuff that I wanted and I got it now.
I was shocked because I never had a room like that nice before.
Fun. Because you have more space to do and you have more freedom.
K
care was taken to make sure the family's personal favorite things were added to the rooms.
My Stiller symbol.
Justin Bieber. Because he's cute and he's just cute.
I like it because before I never would invite any of my friends over because I was embarrassed. It was so plain. But now everybody comes over and they won't stop coming over.
One of the best things about the new house is what the boys say they no longer have to worry about when they were in the shelter.
When we go to the store, there's like people drinking in the street and start telling us stuff.
Kind of scary because there's always people who yell at each other and there's just guys on the street.
They love their new home and finally get to gather around a table and break bread together. The other good news is that Dad Gabriel is waiting to start a new opportunity.
Trucking school is only like 4 weeks long, and I'm already pre-hired through a Swift company, transportation. So that's the next step.
Gabriel is a big goal setter, not just for himself, but also his children. What's the main message they get from Dad?
To do good in school and get a good job.
Finally, when the day finished and Dad Gabriel also had a room makeover.
I couldn't sleep that night. I was still overwhelmed with joy because of, you know, we got the housing that we needed and the help that we needed, and to know that we have so many other friends and, you know, positive people in our life that really help us out. Thank you, St. Vincent de Paul.
Clean furniture, and I schmooze with the customers. I'm not the greatest salesman in the world because I tell people what's wrong with things.
That's Judy Marini.
Well, we get really dirty and sweaty, and I actually try and wear gloves sometimes so my hands aren't as filthy.
That's Pam, Judy's daughter.
In fact, the first day I arrived there, everybody hugged me. Didn't know any of them.
That's John, Pam's brother, Judy's son.
For me, because it's a choice I made, it's not something I have to do.
And that's Ken. He's not related to John, Pam, or Judy. But they all have one thing in common. They love, I mean love, volunteering at Aussie's. If you haven't shopped there, it's St. Vincent de Paul's Uptown Boutique with low-down prices.
There's some nice kids' books here today.
Just ask Pam, a historian who spends her time at the warehouse looking for that special treasure to sell. Her favorite find, an antique dye case.
Oh, somebody donated one and it had 135 packets of dye with it. It was at least 100 years old. Yes, it was. And it was the ones I saw them online for up to like $4,000, and they didn't even have the dye packets. But that's something that you got a deal at Aussie's. Someone got it for $1,000.
Aussie's would not exist without its volunteers like John and Ken, who, among other things, unload trucks with new merchandise, just waiting to be snapped up by some lucky customer.
Ken is amazing. There's nothing that I have to ask him to do because he just does it. He's got so much initiative. He just looks around and finds things to do in the store all the time.
Anything I can do to help out. I help customers. I help them load their purchases. I organize books and CDs, refurbish items before they're put out for sale.
When I'm at that store and I see a big old table or what have you with a sold sign on it and it's going out the door, I know that night somebody is going to get a hot meal because of that.
John's mother, Judy, who was a nurse with the Red Cross, not only volunteers at Aussie's, but at the St. Vinny's thrift store in Pine Top with her husband, who helped build it.
She's very supportive. She, you know, she'll go get us lunch. She just has this personality that keeps us all in line, actually.
In line? Maybe a chorus line, especially during the holidays. Judy loves coming to Aussie's, and it's not just because it's fun and there are hugs all around.
And I think we're put on this earth to help other people that can't help themselves. And we never know when we're going to need help.
For me personally, when I enter the store, it's almost palpable the amount of love that's there as soon as you walk in. It's just like walking into a church.
When I'm not doing any volunteer work, I feel a void in my life. It's like all volunteering, I think, you get more back than you give. It's really, it makes you feel good.
For me, because it's a choice I made, it's not something I have to do. I'm motivated. I always look forward. I volunteer on Monday afternoons. I always look forward to it.
So I do believe we're here to help each other. That's it. Bottom line, if Jesus was walking around right now, that'd be his number one on his list of things to get through our heads. Look, folks, I put you here. You're supposed to help each other, you know.
What is life all about but helping other people?
I should have been a cowboy. I should have learned to rope and ride. Wearing my six shooter, riding my pony on a cattle drive. Stealing a young girl's heart, just like Gene and Roy, singing those campfire songs. Oh, I should have been a cowboy.
Look at that line of some would-be cowboys and girls who once a year get to shop at the St. Vincent de Paul Apache Junction thrift store during its ever-popular Southwestern sale. Of course, no Western rider is complete without the perfect boots, and no one knows shoes on sale more than volunteer Linda Conway. Actually, Linda knows about all of the items for sale, and manager Randy Miller is thrilled.
She was more than willing and excited to jump in and help us with just about anything we need. Everything she does is wonderful. She's task-oriented. She believes whether you're getting paid or not, you know, the job should be done right.
So what I do mostly is put clothes on the racks or straighten up the houseware department, and I like all of that because I can be with the people and I to visit with the customers because I'm kind of a people person.
Like Linda, Lee Gamash is a volunteer who feels that the people she works with are family. And where did Lee get the drive to work this hard with no pay?
That was my mom and my dad. They give and give and give. They're a pastor's and pastor's wife. So they give, and it's always about others.
And by the number of hours Lee donates, she's just like her parents.
She'll come in just about every day, all day long. She puts a lot of time and effort in. She'll help unload trucks, stock merchandise, to the register, and she also is a volunteer coordinator here.
And so is Linda Conway, but she feels that visiting with a customer is just as important as helping with the merchandise.
But then I get to thinking that maybe that person was lonely and hadn't talked to anybody for a day or so, and if I can just fill in that little bit of a void, I feel really good about it.
I always remember you. No matter what happens, someone has it worse than you.
Lee feels good about volunteering because she has big plans for the future.
I am actually in going to school online for business. So I eventually want